Good afternoon, good morning, my brothers and my sisters all over the world. I hope every one of us are doing great. I greet you all in the name of God and in the name of our ancestors. Yes, today is 29 November 2020. I'm live today because of a topic which says your origin between the language you speak, your origin between the language you speak. There's two different things. Yes, the topic is your origin, the difference between your origin and the language you speak. The difference between your origin and the language you speak. Good morning, good afternoon, my beloved brothers and my sisters all over the world. This is Great Benin Emancipation. Our heritage is our pride. You are welcome to today's show. The topic of our today's show is the origins between your language, the language you speak, and your origin. They are different things. They are not the same. That is to say, if I speak Igbo, does not qualify me as an Igbo person. That is to say, somebody. How do I add? I wanted to add somebody here. I'm sorry, my brothers and my sisters. Before we continue, let me pin down my phone number to call after the topic. If you want to contribute to our today topic, you are free to contribute, but not now. I will give you guys the time to call to contribute let me pin down the number to call first. That's the number to call. That is the number to call. Our topic today, the topic of our lesson today, our topic today is that the difference between your origins and the language you speak. The difference between your origins and the language you speak. Two different things. My origin and the language I speak. I speak different language. Does not make me an origins of those tribes that speak the language. Like I speak Italian. I speak English, does not make me a British. I speak Italian, does not make me an Italian. I speak Igbo, does not make me an Igbo. I speak Yoruba, does not make me a Yoruba. Your personality, your origin, is in your DNA, where you are coming from. Your ancestry, that's what makes you who you are, not the language you speak. The person you are, for you to clarify, to certify yourself, that's to say, I am an Italian, not by birth, like the way they see, not by having a citizenship, I mean by origin. So we now go back to our country, our dear country, Nigeria. We know we have a lot of problem now in Nigeria. Everybody is coming up with different names and the other. The main purpose and the main reason why I came up with this topic is because I've listened to so many media debate, social media debate on Facebook and so on. I'm seeing a place whereby the IPOB people are saying that the people that speak Igbos, because they speak Igbo language, because they bear Igbo language, that clarify them, certify them as an Igbo. That is a capital no. So also it is the Yoruba. Not everybody that speak Yoruba language that are ancestry to the Yoruba people. Not everybody that speak Igbo or bear Igbo names or bear Yoruba names that are ancestry to the Yoruba or to Igbo. Likewise, the Midwest. Not everybody that are in Midwest now that are really ancestry to the Midwest people. But the fact is that all the descendants of the Midwest Benders, they are all from the Benin Empire by origin, not by the language they speak, not because we are in Midwest Benin, because we speak Urobo, Ishekiri, Edo, Ishan, Isako, Ikwere, Kwale, and all the rest. Those language does not differentiate anybody. What make them to become one, what make them a Midwest Benin is the ancestry. Their ancestry is what make them who they are. So the language you speak does not identify you as a person. The language you speak does not identify your origin or your ancestry. But it is your ancestry, your DNA that testify, that qualify you to be of whichever tribe you are. You understand? So not everybody that, like me, I speak Igbo. I understand Igbo perfectly, but I am not an Igbo. I understand Urobo. I understand Urobo very well, because I am also a Benin man. Urobo and Benin, they are of the same ancestry. We are not talking about the language. We are not talking about the language we speak now. We are talking about the ancestry. We are all connected by ancestral, not by language. Not even by where you find yourself, but by ancestral. That is how we are connected. So I'm giving a sound warning to these IPOB people and these Briafa people that are saying, because you speak Igbo, you are a Briafa. Because you bear Igbo name, you are Briafa. It's a capital no. That is a big lie. You understand? If I bear Italian names here, does not make me Italian. Just like my family, we are very many in Europe. My children's here in Italy, and my cousin's children's in Austria and in Germany, in London, they speak different languages. My kids here can speak Italian, while my cousin's children can speak Austria, Dutch language, or English. Those languages they speak does not separate them, does not make them who they are, but the ancestry, the ancestral, is what make them one, is what make them same family. So to the Igbo people that are saying, because you speak Igbo, you answer Igbo name, you are an Igbo, that you are just deceiving yourself. You are deceiving yourself. You need to wake up from your sleep. You need to wake up from your sleep. You understand? There's difference between origins and this language you speak. There is difference between your origin, your ancestral home, and the language you speak. There's big difference in it. It's possible for somebody to speak a different language of the language of his ancestral home. It's very possible. But that does not change his ancestry. Just like what is happening today. When you are going to do your ancestral DNA test, when you want to do your DNA test, they don't do your DNA test by the language you speak. They do your DNA test by your ancestral. Your ancestral, the blood connection. That is how they do it. They don't do it because of the language you speak. If I speak English today, does not make me a British. And if I speak Dutch today, does not make me a Dutch. If I speak Italian today, does not make me Italian. And if I bear Italian name, does not make me Italian. What matters is your ancestry. We hear today, everybody, this one is claiming Oduduwa, the other one is claiming Biafra and all the rest. And another thing I want to put to it again is that I also hear them saying the Biafra. I hear them saying, no, don't say the Abrafa. It is referendum that will say it. It is referendum that will determine whether there will be a Biafra or there will not be a Biafra. I want to tell you today, my Biafra people. If you are waiting for referendum, as it stands in Nigeria today, if there is going to be a referendum in Nigeria as it is today, the only people that are going to do or vote for referendums are the Easterners and the West and the Northerners. The South Side, which is the Midwest Bend, they are not going for referendum anymore because we have already done our referendum. Our referendum have already been done in the year 1963. So we don't need referendum. So it is you guys it is the Biafra that will have to go and do referendum whether to join Benin Empire or not. It is the Biafra, the Midwest, Eastern. It is the Eastern, the Biafra, that have to call for referendum. If you people need referendum. One, it's two things you people have to go for, do referendum for. Two or three things. One, you have to do referendum if you want to remain as a Nigeria. Or you do referendum if you want to become a Biafra. Or you do a referendum if you want to join the Benin Empire, the Midwest Bend. Those are the things you have to do. If you are waiting for the South South, the Niger Delta, the Midwest to do referendum, to join you to do referendum, you are just wasting your time. Because our referendum has been done in the year 1963. We have done our referendum. So if you are hoping or you are thinking that when the way Nigeria is today, if they want to call for referendum, the only people that will do referendum are the Easterners, the West, and the Northerners. Those are the three sections that will go for referendum. The South Side, the Midwest, we have already done our referendum. Okay. So if you are waiting for a referendum, if you do a referendum that the Midwest, the South Side, will now vote to join Biafra, that is a big lie. The only area where the Midwest or the South Side will do a referendum, if South Side is doing referendum, the eastern hand or the western hand or the northern hand, it does not concern you people. It is we within us that will do the referendum. They will not do referendum either to remain as a Midwestern, as a Benin Empire, or as to go on their way. But if you are waiting for the South South to do referendum to come and join you, it's a big lie. It can't happen because we already have our referendum. The only people that need to do referendum, if you need it, is the East, the West, and the North. The Midwest been there. The Benin Empire has already showed to you people, Wazobia. Benin Empire has already showed to you people that they are stand. You understand? Blood and water does not mix together. The Benin Empire has already showed to you people in the year 1963 that blood and water does not mix together. They stand their stand. They let you people know their ancestry, who they are, by the referendum that was called in the year 1963. They already showed you people their stance that they are not Biafra, they are not Oduduwa. So if you are waiting, if you think there is going to be a referendum in Midwest Bende to determine if there is going to be a Biafra or no Biafra, or if there is going to be Oduduwa or there is no Oduduwa, it's not going to happen in Midwest Bende. It is not going to happen in Niger Delta, as you may call it. There is no referendum in Niger Delta. We are not complaining. We know ourselves. We know who we are. No, because we speak different languages. No, because by ancestral, we know we are all of the same father, the same mother. We are all of the same empire. We know who we are. We made it clear to you people in the year 1963. We made it clear our stand that we know who we are. We are the Benin Empire. We are the Igodomigodo. We are the Ubini Nokpero. We made it clear right from the beginning. So if you are not clamoring, you want a South South or Midwest Bende or Niger Delta to come and be your Biafra, you will wait until further notice. You will wait until this earth finish. You will wait and you will not get it. The only area whereby you will get your Biafra, I want to tell you, the only area is that you go and call on your five states to do a referendum if really they need a Biafra, not to come to Midwest Bende, the South Side, and be making noise in our ear. All those things you guys are doing in social media, in Facebook, YouTube, and all the rest, it's noise. You know, you people make noise. You people make noise. It is only noise you guys are making. If you are waiting a referendum in Midwest Bende, you will wait and you will die. You will not see it. Except you go to your east, your five east state, to go and conduct a referendum. If your brothers and your sister need Biafra, if you put your longer throat on the South Side or the Midwest Bende, you are shooting yourself. You are shooting your leg. You are shooting your leg. Because we already made it clear to you people that we are of the same ancestry. Despite that we speak different languages, we know who we are. We are of the same father, the same mother, the same ancestry, the same culture. We know who we are. So the Benin Empire know who they are. We made it clear in the year 1963, our stand. The only constitutional region, as it stands today, as a Nigeria stand today, the only constitutional region, the only region that is constituted in Nigeria history is Midwest. Every other ones are cataphic. All the Biafra you are calling, the Oduduwa you are calling, is a cataphic. All of them, they are counterfeit. They are all counterfeit. They are fake. No real. Okay, I want to make it very clear now, this way. Let's make it very clear this way. At first, the Midwest Bende stand for a regional pattern of government, which help us in the earlier stage of Nigeria. We all know how everything was moving fine in the earlier stage of Nigeria. But by the time these people come up with Wazobia and everything, you guys spoil everything. And one thing I want to make clear to every one of you that are well learned, well educated, I want to make it very clear to you that the only constitution region that is recognized all over the world is Midwest Bende. Midwest. Every other one are counterfeit. All the states we find, you find here today, all the old states you find, the Delta, Port Harcourt, River, Enugu, Gbagba, all the states you people are just, you just form. All the states you guys form, all those are counterfeit. When it comes to in history of Nigeria, those states, when a Nigeria break today, if Nigeria cease to exist, there will be no state. There will be no state. It will be of regional pattern, the way it is. When Nigeria cease to exist today, if Nigeria cease today, everybody will go the way they come. Everybody will go the way they come. They will not come, they will not go because of the language they speak. They will not go because of the language they speak. They will all go apart, ancestral differences. They will go different ancestral differences. They will go to their connection, that their ancestral home. That is what we connect them together. If Nigeria sees today, everybody will go with what he came with. So, if you don't know what you came with before Nigeria was amalgamated, if you don't know, you have to start reading those history, not those fake history you are putting on Wikipedias and Google and all the rest. Not those ones. You have to go back before the year 1914. You have to go and study how you were before the year 1914. You understand? Even before the year 1987, you have to go back to go and study, to go and see how you were. Because if Nigeria ceases to exist today, if Nigeria ceases, you will all go back the way you were in the year 1987. 1987, you will all go back. No, in the year 1897. Was it not? No, in the year 1897. You will go back. They amalgamate Nigeria together in the year 1914. We all know. Benin Empire starts to exist in the year 1897. In the year 1897, that is when Benin Empire ceased to exist. So, ever since, all are all counterfeit. All the put together Wazobia are fake. They are all fake. So, if it happened today, like everybody is clamoring for division, everybody is clamoring Biafra, Oduduwa. I want to make it clear to you people now that if it happened today that Nigeria ceased to exist, you all will go back the way you were, how you was in the year 1897. That is how you all will go back. Not now, not the way you find yourself now. Not the corruptions that you have enriched yourself, stolen all the land of the Benin Empire, stolen every part by your corrupt British that bring you people. These same people, these same Wazobia, were the same people that colonized with the British to bring down the Benin Empire. These same people. These same people, immediately they got the independence. These same people immediately formed Wazobia, make Wazobia, turn the area to become Wazobia. They put the main people, they put the main people down, start stealing their land, changing their everything. Immediately, just can you imagine when the Midwest Bende go for referendum, they get their referendum, constitutional referendum, they get it. What happened? The Wazobia people immediately remove history from the school because they don't want anybody to know history anymore. They remove history from the school because they don't want the younger ones to know what has happened. But they fail because the great Benin Empire has its own way of teaching its history, even without going to school. Before education came to that area, the Benin Empire was already learned, okay? So there is no trick that you all will form that we will not know. You know, there is no trick. So if it, as it stands today, if Nigeria ceases to exist, everybody will go the way it was. Benin Empire will claim its territory back. If you don't know, now that we are even helping you people, trying to tell you people that to fight a war is no good, we should come and settle everything amicably. You people think the Benin Empires are scared of anything or afraid? Or you people think the Benin Empire don't know their history? Or they don't know where they are coming from? We all know. We know everything. We know everything. We know where we are coming from. We know our history. We will tell it better than you. We are just trying to make peace so that everybody will go on as a regional government. As it is in the year 1963, we are telling every one of you to go and let everybody govern their regions. But you people are thinking that we don't have sense, or we are stupid, or maybe we don't know our history, or we don't know who we are. We know who we are. If you people don't like it that way, if you people don't like it for every region to govern their territory, then the benefit we are giving you people, we will take it back from you people. Because we know the territory of Benin Empire. Don't forget that there was a sovereignty before Nigeria. Benin was a sovereignty before Nigeria. Benin was having embassy in Portugal. I hope you all know this history. So if it happens today, then Nigeria break, that everybody should go on their way. Everybody will go how they come. Everybody. The East, you all go how you come. The Yoruba, you all go how you come. The North will go the way they come. While the Benin Empire will stay, will take all what you guys are stolen from them back. You all know. We all know the Benin territory. So all the place that Benin Empire was situated in that Nigeria was not by conquering. We did not conquer. We are aboriginal to those places. So you people should not think that when it happened, everybody go their way. Everybody go The only people that has the right to go their way are the people who were conquered to Benin Empire before. And in the history, those Benin territory, there was no conqueror. The Benin did not conquer. The Benin Empire are aborigine to those areas of Benin Empire. So the language you speak does not determine your origin. What makes you a Benin person or a Benin Empire? It is by ancestral. What makes you an Igbo person? It is by ancestral, not by the language you speak, not by the place, the present place you find yourself. What makes you a Yoruba man? It is by your ancestral, not by the Yoruba you speak. What makes the Benin Empire a Benin Empire? It is by the ancestral connection, not by the language we speak differently. So there is difference between language you speak and your origin. That is why when you want to do your DNA test, you want to go and do a DNA. These people that are looking for their ancestral home, where they come from, like the American, like what is happening today everywhere, want to know where they come from. They do it by ancestral DNA test, not by language DNA test, not by the name you bear DNA test, not by the language you speak DNA test, not by the position you find yourself DNA test. They do it ancestral DNA test. That makes you who you are, not the language you speak, not the name you bear. The ancestral is what makes you your tribe, what makes you the tribe you are. So we, the Midwest, the Benin Empire, we are of the same ancestral, the same ancestry. We are of the same family, the same father, the same mother. We are connected by ancestry. We are connected together by our ancestry, not by the language we speak. So if you put it to your head that because of they speak different language, you will separate them, it's a big lie. Because we did not come together at first because of the different languages we speak. We came together as a Benin Empire because of the same ancestry that connected us together. So you have to get that clear. Let it clear to you. The Breafa, the Oduduwa, you guys have to know when did Breafa came into existence and when did Oduduwa came into existence. Oduduwa Republic, there's no even Breafa Republic. What am I saying? There's no even Breafa. It's not known anywhere. It's not known. It's not everywhere. It's just a lip say. Oduduwa Republic is a lip say. It's not known anywhere. It's not in any history. The only name that is recognized all over the world, the only empire recognized, is Benin Empire. It's recognized all over the world. There was a Benin Empire before Nigeria. There was a Benin Servitry before Nigeria. Benin Embassy. Benin Empire Embassy before Nigeria have an embassy. So you guys just have to, when you are looking for your Breafa, you shift yourself to the angle where you know you can find Breafa. And when you are looking for Oduduwa, you shift yourself to the area whereby you can find Oduduwa. If you are looking for Oduduwa Republic in Midwest, in Benin Empire territory, you shoot your leg. If you are looking for Breafa in Benin Empire territory, Midwest, you have already shot your leg. My IPOP, you have already shot your leg if you are looking for Breafa in South South, as you may call it, or Niger Delta, or Midwest, or in Benin Empire. You have already shot your leg because you will not get it. you remain dreaming. And to the Oduduwa people, I've seen in Facebook, in media, you guys are drawing map everywhere. You draw map of today. You say the map was drawn in the year 90, no date. You draw map yesterday. You said the map was drawn in the year 2020, in the year 1414. You guys are just kidding and fooling yourself. You guys are all fooling yourself everywhere. I'm here to advise you guys. If you want to get your Biafra, take it to the area where you know you will get your Biafra. If you want to get Oduduwa Republic, take it to the area where you know you will get your Oduduwa Republic. Otherwise, let everybody come up again. Let everybody govern itself as a regional pattern, the way it was in the year 1963. No, but you people refuse. You people refuse it because you people want to eat from where you people did not sow. That is why you guys start destroying it. Start changing, making state, dividing state, bringing disunity to brothers and sisters. The Wazobia, the problem we have today is caused by Wazobia. How can you imagine? You said three names, three tribes or three language is greater than 250 something language we have in that area called Nigeria. That is greediness. And the greediness that you people brought is what is bringing the problem we have today in Nigeria. That's the problem we have in Nigeria today. You want to be Alpha. You want to be Omega. You want to be everything. You want to take a glory of another people. You want to take glory of another people. You people want to take glory of another people. That is why you people will not get, you will not get Biafra, you will not get Oduduwa. Or thing you people bring everything to board and say it the way it is. In the year 1897, when the Benin Empire were fighting war with the British, where were you? Where were Oduduwa Republic? In the year 1897, when the Benin Empire was fighting war with the British, where were the IPOB, the Biafra? Where were you? Where were you when the Benin were fighting the British? These same people were the people that colonized with the British to fight against the Benin Empire. These same people do all means to make sure that they destroy Benin Empire. When it comes to a time whereby they say, okay, let Nigeria get freedom, immediately the British go. These same people that was working with the British people, immediately they change it, they make it Wazobia. Where was Wazobia? Where were you in the year 1897? Where were your location? It's not found anywhere. We all know where you guys were in the year 1897. We know where the Igbos, we know where you people were in the year 1897. We know where your territory, we know it. The Yoruba, we know where you people were in the year 1897. We know your territory. We know where you people were. We know it. We know where you people are. So, you guys just have to tranquilo, eh? Don't go and bite what you cannot chew. In Benin parable, they said, Awe nobo kange zakon hara. Sokma nomya kwara nunoya gwei. You don't tell a child not to have a rough teeth or a big teeth. He can have a big teeth or big teeth, shovel teeth, in as far that he can have a lips to cover it. If you don't have a lips to cover it, that's where you have problem. You can say anything you want to say on social media, on anywhere you want to say, Biafra and whatever. When it comes to table talk, when it comes to a time of table talk, that is, let's bring everything to the table and talk it. You go and bring your evidence, the rest other bring your evidence. If you don't have your evidence, that's where you shoot yourself. Because we, the great Benin Empire, we have evidence. We have more than evidence to tell you who we were and who we are. To tell you how we were and who we are today. We have more than evidence. So, for you, those of you, the Yoruba, the Biafra, that are saying, because you speak a similar language to my language, that make you a Yoruba. You are lying. Make yourself a big lie. For those of you that say, because you speak Igbo language, or you speak a language that looks similar to Igbo language, then you are Igbo. Yeah, that is another big lie. You can be only connected to people by ancestral, not by the language you speak, not by the name you bear. You can only be connected to the people, not by the language you speak, not by the name you bear. You can only be connected to a people, to a group of people, to a tribe of people, not by the language you speak, not by the tribe, the language you speak, and not by the name you bear. That is to say, because you speak English, does that make you a British? Because I speak Italian, does that make me an Italian? Or because I speak Igbo language, does that make me an Igbo? Or because I bear Igbo name, does that make me an Igbo? No, capital no. What make me who I am, it is by ancestral. By ancestral connection, not by the language connection, not by the name connection. I hope every one of us are getting us now. I'm here to warn those Biafra people that are saying, because the people in South South, most of them speak Igbo language, that makes them an Igbo person. That is a big lie. You are just fooling yourself. You people forget that by intermarrying, names and language can cross. You guys know, by intermarrying people, by staying together, by staying close to different tribe, the language can change and the name also can change. But that does not change your ancestral background. It does not change your ancestry lineage. It does not change your ancestry tribe. By intermarrying, or by staying together, or by living long in a place, does not make you automatically ancestral to that place. The only thing that make you ancestral to the marriage is by ancestral lineage, not by the language, not by the name you bear. So, I'm warning you people now. You people should deviate from those stupid things you guys are doing on media and on Facebook and on YouTube and everywhere. You people should deviate from it. If we are keeping you people quiet, does not mean that we don't know who we are. And don't forget, they said, who laughed last laugh better. Okay. You guys remember when the Nigeria, when they got independent, what happened? The Biafra, the Wazobia, the Wa people, the Zo people, the Bia people, they started stealing land, started occupying land that is not belong to them. Immediately their master run away from them. Immediately their master go back to their to British. What happened? The Zo people, the Wa people, the Bia people, they started putting hand, they started stealing, started occupying places. When the Benin Empire see this thing, they say, no, this thing cannot happen. That is why our forefather came up and said, no, we are not Yoruba, neither we are Biafra. We are Benin Empire. We are Benin Empire. So you people did not believe. You people did not believe. Then what did you people do? You people say, okay, they should do referendum. And when they did the referendum in the year 1963, what happened? You all see, more than 100 and something voted to be a Midwest. That is to tell you, to be a Benin Empire. Okay? So they know everybody in Midwest Bende, the South Side, as you may call it, the Benin Empire, we know who we are. We know where we are. We know where we are coming from. We are connected together ancestrally, but not by language, not by the name we bear. We are connected ancestrally. So, if you are not connected to Niger Delta or South Side or Midwest ancestrally, don't bring your Biafra to that place. In Midwest Bende, in Great Benin Empire, there's nothing like Biafra. When did Biafra come into existence? When did Oduduwa came into existence? Even the Yoruba, when did they come into existence? When did they bring you people together? The Igbos. We were there. That place, we were there. We are aboriginal to that area. You guys all meet us there. So if it happened today that Nigeria want to break up, if it happened today, Nigeria break up today. If it happened that Nigeria break up, because even the Nigeria today, nobody is benefiting the Nigeria. The most people who has benefited the Nigeria, it is the Wazobia people that have benefited this Nigeria. All the great Benin Empire children and the grandchildren, great-grandchildren, are being marginalized by this same core people, Wazobia people. You guys have marginalized us. We keeping you guys quiet does not mean we are a fool. We are not a fool. We are not a fool. It's just that we are peace making people. So as you can see, Benin Empire as a whole, all the territory of Benin Empire is not a conquer. It is occupied. We are aboriginal to every area that the Benin Empire is occupied. We are aboriginal to it, not by conquer. We did not conquer it we did not take it from anybody. We are aboriginal to those areas. We use it to hunt, we farm, we produce. When we were farming, when we were hunting, when we were industrial, there is nothing like Igbo. When the Benin Empire was empire, when it was farming, when it was hunting, when there were creativity, there's nothing like Igbo. There's nothing like Yoruba. By the way, Yoruba came from the name Yariba. Everybody know that. So you guys should not bite what you cannot chew. Don't bite what you can't chew. That is what I'm here to tell you people. With the Benin Empire, the Midwest, the South Side, as you may call it, we know ourselves. We are all one. We are all one. So, your names and your the language you speak and your origin is a three different things. Speaking your language does not, speaking Yoruba does not make you a Yoruba person. Speaking Igbo does not make you an Igbo person. Bearing a Yoruba name does not make you a Yoruba. Bearing an Igbo name does not make you an Igbo person. Okay, that is that. As you can see in Benin Empire, we have different languages. Different languages, different names, but the same ancestry. We are of the same ancestry, the same father, the same family. We know who we are. Like I said before, oil and water can never mix together. Anywhere Benin origin, Benin Empire great-grandchildren, descendant, anywhere they are, they make themselves clear. You will know them. You don't need to run in scatter before you know them. We know ourselves. Wherever you find great Benin descendant, wherever you find great Benin children, wherever you find them, you know them. You know them not by their names, not by the language they speak. You know them by ancestral, connection. That is how you know them. So the first thing I will go and ask, I will ask the Biafran and the Odudu what to do is for them to go and look for their ancestral, who they are, where they come from. The same goes to the Igbos. You go and do your ancestry and know where you are coming from. Not because you speak Igbo language or you bear Igbo names, that does not make you an Igbo. Because you speak Yoruba or you answer Yoruba name does not make you a Yoruba person. You go and do your find out, go and check who you are by knowing your ancestry. You can bear Italian name, you can bear Dutch name, you can bear English name, does not make you Italian, does not make you British, does not make you Dutch. Your ancestry, it is what make you who you are, not the language or the name you bear. So get it clear. Get it clear. We the great Benin, we know ourselves. We know who we are. We know who we are. If it happens today that Nigeria sees, to exist, what happened automatically is that everything that Nigeria has brought will cease. If you people don't know, if Nigeria sees today that there is no Nigeria anymore, everything that Nigeria bring will cease. There will be no state, no Delta state as you may call it, no Enugu state, no other state. You will not find it anymore. Everything that Nigeria bring will cease. What will now come on board will be what has been before Nigeria came into being. You people have to know this very well. You people have to know this very well. That if Nigeria sees today, everything that Nigeria bring, that has bring on board, will cease. Okay? That is to say, Wazobia cease. That is to say, there is no Wazobia. That is to say, everybody to your tent. That is to say, everybody to your father house. When Nigeria sees today, that is to say, everybody to your father house. The fact is that we should call a spade a spade. Yes, we should not be trying to change things because of one thing or the other. No. If it happens as it is today, nobody's benefiting the Nigeria constitution. Nobody's benefiting from Nigeria government. Nobody. And as it is that nobody's benefiting from Nigeria government, the most people that are the most marginalized people in this Nigeria as it is the Benin Empire, the descendant of Benin, not the Wa, not the Zo, not the Bia people. You people have been benefiting. You people have been eating from where you people did not sow. You people have been eating from where you people did not sow. Where you people were eating on where you people did not sow. You people were on power. There was no problem. There's no problem. Immediately that you people are losing some powers in the government paramilitaries. Now there's problem. Immediately there's Oduduwa. Immediately there's Biafra. And the funniest thing is that you people will be calling Biafra and calling Oduduwa. And you people forget. You people forget one thing. I don't know why. I don't know. Is this stupidity that you people forget that before Biafra, before Oduduwa, let's say for example. Okay, let's say the way it is now. You people are calling Biafra. You people are calling Oduduwa. It is the Nigeria that brought this Biafra and Oduduwa. If Nigeria ceases today, there will be no Oduduwa and there will be no Biafra. There will be only Benin Republic. That's Great Benin Empire. There will be only Great Benin Empire. That was the only territory, sovereignty, before the British came. It was a sovereignty. If you people don't know. Yes. Yes, my brother Samudia, man. They don't know. Are you guys hearing me? Samudia, are you guys hearing me? I've been speaking since I did not even ask. Are you guys hearing me? Yes. There is difference between the language you speak and the name you bear and your ancestry. A big difference. There is a big difference. There's a big difference. As you may know, the difference we are always the Benin Empire is always example to everything in this world. Benin Empire is always example. Like in Benin Empire, we speak. In Benin Empire, we speak different languages. We speak different languages. We bear different names. But we know we are of the same ancestry. We know that we are of the same ancestry. We know we are of the same ancestry. We know that we are of the same ancestry. So the name you bear or the language you speak does not make you who you are. What makes you who you are is your ancestry, your connection to your tribe. Your ancestry DNA is what makes you who you are. I want to tell you the Biafra. I want to tell you the Oduduwa that are drawing map all over the world, trying to encroach the Benin Empire. You guys should deviate from it, because even the map you draw will not give you Oduduwa. The map you draw will not give you Biafra. I speak Igbo. Language does not make me a Biafra person or Igbo person. I bear Igbo names does not make me Igbo person or a Biafra person. I speak Yoruba or I bear Yoruba name does not make me a Yoruba. This should go to you people head. It should enter your skull. There was a Benin sovereignty before Nigeria was created. great Benin Empire sovereignty. There was a Benin embassy, Great Benin Empire embassy, before even Nigeria have their own embassy. So, as it is today, we don't pray for Nigeria to break. Nobody is happy the way Nigeria is. Right from day one, right from the year 1897, the Great Benin Empire has never been happy, even till now. We are not happy the way things are. These same Wazobia people are the people that colonized with the British to fight the Benin Empire. Immediately the British, their coal master left, what happened? The same Wazobia start stealing land, start dragging what does not belong to them, start taking them. But they forget one thing, that we are connected spiritually, ancestrally. The Benin Empire are connected. You understand? We are connected. So if Nigeria sees today, if Nigeria sees, there will be no Biafra, because Nigeria came into existence before Biafra came into existence. Nigeria came into existence before Yoruba or Oduduwa came into existence. Everything that came into existence before, Nigeria will be seized, if you people don't know. If Nigeria sees today that Nigeria is no more anymore, everything that come after Nigeria will cease. The only thing that will rest alone is the thing that will be existing before Nigeria. That is to tell you, if Nigeria sees today, the Benin Empire will claim all their territory back. We all know our territory. That is to tell you, if there is no Nigeria today, automatically there is Benin Empire. That is to tell you, if there is no Nigeria today, automatically there's Benin Empire. And if you fall inside Benin Empire territory, before you go, you have to do your own referendum to go out of the Benin Empire territory. So if you are a Yoruba speaking person and you know that the area you are living is under Benin Empire territory, when Nigeria sees, before you can get that your land, you have to go for referendum. And that referendum, it is the Benin Empire that have to set it for you. Just like the way Nigeria sovereignty set a referendum for the Great Benin descendant. That is how the Great Benin Empire will set a referendum for those stupid people who want to leave the Benin Empire. We know you people, and you guys are very few. You guys are few. So the only thing I will even pray for you people, the people that is calling themselves Biafra and Oduduwa, you guys just have to be praying that everybody should go on regional pattern of government. Pray for that, so that at least you people will also have a space, you also have at least things to stand on. You people have to pray for we to come up with a regionally pattern of government. Otherwise, if you don't want that, and you are praying for breakup, for Nigeria to break, you will shoot your leg. Why do I say so? Because if Nigeria ceases to exist, there will be no Wazobia. Okay? If Nigeria ceases to exist, the only thing that will come to exist is Benin Empire. Benin Empire sovereignty. That is the only thing that will come to exist. Yes, that is it. It's just like a house. It's just like a house. When you build a very big house, you build a big house. You build a very big house. When you build a house, and when it comes to a time that the house break, maybe there's earthquake, and the house break down, all the windows, the roofing, and all the rest of the house, they will all fall away. But the land where the house is built on top will remain there. The earthquake will not take it away. Nothing will happen to that land that house were built on top. That is how Benin Empire is. Nigeria, as it is today, is built on top Benin Empire. Nigeria, as it is today, is built on Benin Empire. And if it break, just like I make example before, a house, when you build a house, you know, you guys know that when you build a house, there's windows, there's roofing, there's so many things that make up a house. But without a foundation, there is no house. Without a foundation, there is no house. So the only foundation that Nigeria is having today is Benin Empire. So if the house break down, break into pieces, the window will go separate, the roof will go separate, everything will go separate, but the foundation remain, it is where it is. The foundation will remain where it is. Then, the people that hold the foundation, if they decide to build it again, they will build it up again, the way it is. That is how Nigeria is. Nigeria's sovereignty is built on the foundation of Great Benin Empire. For those of you that are clamoring for Oduduwa or Biafra, that Nigeria should seize. Yes, me, as a bona fide son of Great Benin Empire, I will be very, very happy for Nigeria to break. Because if Nigeria break, I am not losing anything. I'm gaining. If Nigeria break, I'm gaining. If Nigeria break, I'm gaining. If Nigeria break today, the only people that will be roofing, Benin Empire is a foundation of the Nigeria country, sovereignty. The Nigeria sovereignty is built on the foundation of Benin Empire. And if that foundation, if that building break down, the roof will go, the window will go, everything will go pieces. But the foundation will remain where it is. The foundation will remain there. What am I saying? What am I trying to say? I'm just trying to tell every one of you there, most of the Wazobia people, the Biafra, the Oduduwa, trying to tell you people that you people are very lucky that you people are on the foundation of Great Benin Empire. And with your godfather, you people are be able to manipulate, to be controlling everything, benefiting from where you people did not sow. The way things are going on, if Nigeria break, the people that will suffer it the more are the Oduduwa and the Biafra, not the Benin descendant, not the Benin Empire. If the foundation, the house broke, the foundation remain. It is the Biafra that will go where they came from, and it is the Yoruba, the Oduduwa, who will go where he came from. It is the Oduduwa and the Biafra that will go and look for where they came from. When a house break down, when the house is break down, the foundation remains where it is. Because that foundation is aborigine to that house. So when the house break, everything will go separately and the foundation will remain. So when Nigeria break, as it's going on, you guys, the Biafra and Oduduwa, our ancestors is using you people now to fight for our favor. Our ancestor, the great Benin Empire ancestor, which you people betrayed, are commanding you people now to fight for the great Benin Empire and descendant favor. Nobody is praying for it to happen. But if it happens, you people will find yourself to blame. You people will find yourself to blame. Because when Nigeria breaks down, Biafra will go their way. You people know where you come from. In the recent, if Nigeria breaks down now the way it is, if it breaks, Biafra is not up to three states because the Onitsha are aboriginal to the Benin Empire descendant. If Nigeria break down, the Biafra, you people are not up to three states. Get it to your faco. Get it clear now. If Nigeria break today, the Biafra is not up to three states. The Onitsha are ancestrally to Benin Empire. Get that. And if Nigeria break, the Oduduwa, you call yourself, the Ondo, the Lagos, Eko, all these plates are ancestral to the Benin Empire. Get it to your skull. It's not by the language they speak there. It's not by the name they bear there. It's by the ancestral connection. Is by the ancestral connection. So that is what I am saying. For those of you Biafra, those of you Oduduwa, saying the people in Niger Delta, Southside, they speak Yoruba, they speak close to Yoruba, for that they are Yoruba. It's a capital no. You lie. The language person speak, language where person they speak, in no make her. The personality, the language where person they speak. If the person speak Yoruba, does not make him a Yoruba person. If he bear a Yoruba name, does not make him a Yoruba person. If he speak Igbo, does not make him an Igbo person. If he bear Igbo names, does not make him an Igbo person. So that is it. You all know Nigeria was built on the foundation of Benin territory. Nigeria territory as it is today is built on the foundation of Benin Empire sovereignty. Benin Empire was a sovereignty before Nigeria. Benin Empire was having embassy before Nigeria has their own embassy. Get it to your skull. Get it clear. Get it clear. And there is nothing like Igodomigodo Biafra. When does that name come? It was this year. I started hearing Igodomigodo Biafra. There is nothing like Igodomigodo Biafra. In the year 1897, where we are Biafra, there was nothing, no name like Biafra. In the year 1897, there is nothing like Biafra. In the year 1897, there is nothing like Yoruba. Before the year 1897, there was Benin Empire. Before the year 1897, there was Ubini Nukpevo. Anyway, for those of you that are commenting negative here on my comment section. You are just doing yourself a harm because I don't read your comment. So I'm just going. I don't read your comment. So you can be commenting so that later we know the kind of person you are. We know that everywhere in the internet, in the Facebook, YouTube, everywhere, this same Biafra, Facebook Biafra, everywhere trying to comment, to cause, to do all those things. That is to know them. We know them. You know? Ekmo Biokme, Bini say, tiger give birth to tiger. A warrior give birth to warriors. Why queens give birth to queen? What do I say? Tiger give birth to tiger. Kings give birth to kings. Queens give birth to queens. Warrior give birth to warrior. The great Benin Empire, they are tiger. They are warriors. They are kings. They are queens. So we are queens. Tiger give birth to tiger. And kings give birth to kings. Warrior give birth to warriors. And queens give birth to queens. Get it clear. When a queen is born, when a queen put birth to a baby girl, automatically he becomes a queen. And when a king give birth to a baby boy, automatically he become a king. And when a warrior give birth to any child, automatically he becomes a warrior. So I want to let you all know, all the great Benin descendants, great Benin all over the world, that you all are warriors. You are all kings and queens. You are all tigers. So don't let anybody bring you down. Know your right and stand on your rights. We know who we are. Know your history. Know your history by the source. There's another thing that these stupid people keep saying, that these stupid people, whenever you ask this, hello.
Hello.
Hello, my brother. Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman.
Sorry, Kevin.
Yes, Kevin.
I think I'll raise speaker, sir.
I'll raise speaker.
No, you speak in
it. Okay, any more speaker?
Yeah.
Okay. Kumegwa. Hello. Hey, imoine. Yeah, okay. Kumegwa ituna. But we ma kama we 3 o'clock we are. Hey, 3 we are online. Huh? Okay now. But on our user. I be all in and we here. Huh? Okay. Mamana later. Yeah, look at him. Bye bye. Okay, as I was saying, that the language you speak and the name you bear does not clarify or certify your origin. Does not give you your origin. Your origins is by ancestral. So means you speaking Yoruba or Biafra does not make you a Yoruba or a Biafra. You staying in other people's territory does not give you the right, does not give you the right to that territory. You are only a visitor. For those of you Biafra that are saying they are Igbos in the Midwest, in the South Side. If Igbos are in the South Side, does that make the South Side a Biafra? Or if Igbos they are in the northern part of the Nigeria, does that make the northern part a Biafra? If the Yoruba people are in Igbo, in Biafra, does that make them Oduduwa? If Yoruba speaking people are in Midwest, does that make Midwest Oduduwa? No, it's a capital no. The name you bear or the language you speak does not make you who you are. What make you who you are, your origin, is by ancestral connection. Okay, as it is, the Nigeria, as it is, as a country, is built on a sovereign, on a foundation of Great Benin Empire. So if Nigeria break today, everybody will go their way, while the Benin Empire will remain where it is. The Benin Empires are aboriginal to wherever they are. All the Benin Empire states and origins, they are aboriginal to that place. They never meet anybody there. They never conquer anybody there. We are aboriginal to it. So that is that. If Nigeria break today, everybody will go your way, their way. The only thing you people has to be thinking about now, worry about the Biafra and the Oduduwa, is to ask yourself, where were you in the year 1897? Even before 1897, where were you? Where were you called? What was your name? Where were you occupying? You have to say that. What is important to you, Biafra and Oduduwa? What is important to you people now? I want to give you people a clear awareness to you people now. The most important thing to you people, what is very important for you people now, is to know who you people, how you people was before the year 1897. Because before the year 1897, where were you? What were you called? Where were you? How were you living? Because if Nigeria break down, that is what you will become. Get it clear. The same goes to Biafra. Where were you in the year 1897? How were you in the year before the year 1897? What were your states and origin before 1897? Because if Nigeria break, that is where you will be. That is what you will become, not what Nigeria has make you be. It is not what Nigeria has make you be that you will become after Nigeria breakdown. When Nigeria break down, everything that come after Nigeria, we go. The only thing that will exist will be the thing that come before Nigeria. Those are the things that exist. And the only thing in those areas that exist before Nigeria came into existence is Great Benin Empire sovereignty. I thank every one of you for listening to me. I'm about to end this video topic. I hope every one of us listen and understand it very well. The topic is the names you bear and the language you speak is different from your ancestral connection. The name and the language you speak does not give you ancestral connection. So the people of Midwest, South, Niger Delta, they are all ancestral to the great Benin Empire. We are of one family. We speak different language, yes. That is why I said language does not change anything. We bear different name, yes. The name does not change anything. We are of the same ancestry, yes. We are of the same ancestry. I thank every one of you for listening to me. I pray that God Almighty and our ancestors will open our faculty to reason well, to listen, to know what is right from what is wrong. I bless every one of you. I hope every one of you are doing well. Happy Sunday. I greet you all. We will see very soon. Thank you all. I greet you all, my beloved brothers and my sister. Don't allow anybody to deceive you, to tell you what you are not. I'm appealing to the Niger Delta people, Niger Delta, South, Midwest. We are all of one ancestry. We are of the same father. We are of the same family. The language we speak and the name we bear does not change anything. The most important, what is important to us, is our ancestral connection. So to the Biafra, if you are not ancestral connected to the great Benin Empire, pack your load. So to the Yoruba, if you are not ancestral connected to the great Benin Empire, pack your load. So what we are clamoring for, even right from the year 1963, our ancestors saw all these things and they said, no, we should all go as a regionary government paramecetus. And when we experience that regional government, we experience change in Nigeria. But when the Wazobia people came, they destroyed it. That was when everything spoiled up to now. So if we want to live in peace in Nigeria as it is now, we should all go back to a regional pattern of government. Or if you people want that Nigeria should cease, you people should have it in back of your mind that if Nigeria cease today, everything that come before Nigeria, everything that come after Nigeria will cease, and everything that come before Nigeria will come into existence. That is to say, if Nigeria cease today, there will be no Oduduwa, there will be no Biafra, but there will be Great Benin Empire sovereignty. Thank you all one more again. I greet you all. Take care. Bye-bye. See you. Let's see. Bye.